Hello everyone, and welcome once more to another exciting edition. Today we will be talking about medical schools in Japan for the health industry. This means this is not just for doctors, it's for nurses, it's for clinicians, for researchers. So everyone is welcome to follow and to gather the maximum information that you have in order to secure you a spot in the University of Tokyo or any other medical university in Japan. So please stay tuned. And if you've not yet subscribed or hit on the notification bell, please, I'm gonna give you a few seconds to do that. You're a great person. Thank you so much for hitting subscribe and the notification bell. Please also remember to share this video, as there are so many people who are aspiring to get into the healthcare industry and they need medical training and they need medical degrees. And Japan is one of those top world countries that you want to get a medical degree from there. So I literally urge you to please follow right up to the end. Today we're going to talk about the University of Tokyo, which is, of course, we all know that the University of Tokyo is one of the prestigious universities in the world, and a lot of people will be struggling, you know, to get an admission or to secure them a spot in the University of Tokyo. So we're going to talk about that today, from what you need to getting an admission. So please stay tuned right up to the end. First off, we will talk about the location. So the University of Tokyo, of course, yeah, it's in Tokyo, the beautiful city. So you wanna study in Tokyo in one of the top ranking universities in the world, University of Tokyo and Medicine. It's pretty easy compared to other, I would say, Ivy institutions in the world, maybe in the West, in the US, or Canada and Australia and the UK. So we will talk about the University of Tokyo. So it's fairly easy to access it once you are in Japan and you enter the address on your Google map. It takes you directly to the Hongar campus, and that is where you have the School of Medicine and the Graduate Schools of Medicine and all derivative or pharmacy. So if you wanna have like direct information or meet the HR team and talk with them, meet the international student department and talk with them, I'll strongly advise you to come to the campus, and you will definitely follow the board, the signs on the notice board, and that can take you to the department where you can be able to talk to the international student department, which will take care or answer any questions that you want. Regarding last year, the University of Tokyo was a very lucrative location for most international students. I know, you know, we had a very hard year with COVID and stuff, but we still had a stunning 13% of, you know, students who came into the University of Tokyo. So that is pretty amazing. That number, it's almost 4,000 international students who got a spot in the University of Tokyo. That is really fascinating. And it's so amazing because it's so affordable. It's really not very complicated and complex to get into University of Tokyo, as we are gonna see in a bit. There is, first of all, an application fee. There is a tuition fee, and there is an admission fee. So these three are very, very important, and is way, way cheaper compared to what you can even imagine compared to universities in the US. And here there is several opportunities, same as in the US, for you to get, like, you know, fully funded scholarship if you're an international student or you're an international practitioner who wants to work in the US, or you want to become a nurse, or you want to become someone in the health industry, or you want to become maybe a biotechnologist or a laboratory technician. All of this, there is possibilities for you to get into this medical school. So it's pretty cheap. I remember when I had admissions into the University of Brandeis to study global health and management, my tuition fee was about a stunning $54,000 per year, even though I had like the top merit-based scholarship of 70%, but it was still hard. You can imagine that. So, but I'm telling you, the fees for University of Tokyo, and you're gonna be like, oh my god. Yeah, that's true. So in the University of Tokyo, the application fee is $147 approximately $147 USD for you to file your application. And I'm gonna talk about the documents that you need for that in a bit. And then after you apply, the next thing is that you have what we call an admission fee. And the admission fee is very cheap. Can you imagine? It's about just $2,700 or $2,500. That is very, very cheap compared to other universities around the world. And next up, your tuition fee, can you imagine that? It's below $5,000 depending on your faculty. That's amazing. So in total, you spend, let's say, $5,000 plus $4,000 plus $148. So that's about $6,148. So that is really, really cheap for you to go through an academic year, all right? And then, of course, that excludes like textbooks that you gotta buy by yourself. That excludes, you know, everything you need, accessories, your computer for your studies, or any other thing that, you know, can be associated with your studies. So if you're a medical student and you have to go through medical school, of course, you know, there's other stuff that you need to buy. You need to buy your stethoscope, you need to buy your otoscope, you need to buy, you know, pulse oximetry just for your personal practice. Of course, you can have that within the settings of the hospital, but it's always good you have your own private equipments for use. Moving on, I'm gonna talk about the requirements that you need for the University of Tokyo, okay? Generally, it's everything we will need for any university abroad. So of course, you will need some form of ID, which could be your passport, your national identity card from your home country, of course, but you will need your passport in order to travel, in order to fly into Japan. So you need your passport, you need your birth certificate, you need copies of your, you know, transcripts or your diploma or certificates from your home university showing that at least you have, you know, an undergraduate degree if you're going in for graduate studies, or that you have completed high school, okay? And usually those should be in English or in Japanese. So if it's in any other language apart from English or Japanese, please, you must attach a certified translation to those before you submit for application. If not, it's gonna be, you know, rejected or discarded. Usually, if you're not from an English-speaking country, of course, we know all the English-speaking countries, you can Google that out, you will find out. So if you're not from an English-speaking country, you need to submit like an English proficiency test, say the TOEFL or IELTS, for proof of your English proficiency, of course, because the University of Tokyo tries to be as international as possible. So they offer courses and lectures in English, with a lot of guest lecturers coming from around the world to offer courses in specific fields that they're experts in. So, and they will usually use English as a medium of communication or of exchange or of lecturing. So it's really, really, very important for you to, you know, submit an IELTS or a TOEFL test if you don't have that. Please, I'm gonna leave the link in the description box below for the requirements. And for the University of Tokyo particularly, you need to take a pre-entrance test. It's very, very important, especially if you're entering into medical schools. So usually it is some kind of language test, first of all. So remember, if you're going into graduate schools, Japanese is not a must initial prerequisite, all right? So Japanese is not a must for the start, but if you are planning to study medicine to become a physician or say a pharmacist, then you need to show proof of Japanese proficiency, because once you start a clinical rotation or the clinical years, you will definitely need to show that you can communicate with your patients in Japanese, which is very, very essential and very, very important. So you will need to show some form of Japanese proficiency. Moving on, what you don't actually need at the admission level in terms of language proficiency is, if you're from an English country and you're following the academic pathway, so like studying to get an academic degree, say in the field of medicine, whatever you want, biochemistry, molecular biology, immunology, whatever, just name it, all right? So if that is your end goal, then you don't absolutely need to show some form of language proficiency, say most importantly Japanese language, because you do most of those in English. Next off is you need to take a pre-entrance examination, and usually it's a language or and mathematics or some form of biology or chemistry. So you have the choice depending again on what you really want to study. So I'm gonna leave the contact information for the international department and their email address in the comment section below, or I'm gonna leave the link to the webpage in the description below so you can check it out and you can contact them. They are very open, they're super nice people, they will help you as much to their ability as they can. So please just be ready, feel relaxed, ask whatever questions you have, and they will respond to you on the regular working hours, Japan time. So that is that for the exam. So you need a pretest, so please have that in mind. And then after you take the pretest, the next thing is that you will wait for the result. Usually it takes about a month and then it's gonna be out. I'm gonna leave the latest information for the academic year of 2022 right in the description box. Please check that out. And then you need to fly to come to Japan. Some schools might want you to have like an interview in person. Some might want you just to submit your application file. Some might, you know, have a remote where y'all have like a conference call, maybe on Zoom or WebEx, I don't know, or Teams. And then they can ask you a couple of questions and then they will tell you, oh, you have this position or not. Again, if you want to go into graduate school, there is also one very important thing that you need to bear in mind. You need to find you a supervisor in the field that you really want to do, because the university is pretty big, right? You just can't come like that, right? So you need someone who's going to be like your mentor, your supervisor, who's going to coordinate your research work. This is very, very important. I'm still going to leave a link for the list of those professors. It's an up-to-date link, you know, for 2022, except things are going to change, you know, later. I don't know when you're going to watch this, but I'm leave the link right in the description box. You can contact them and, you know, you express your interest. If they're interested in working with you, they will tell you, oh, that's fine. We can mentor you, or I can be your mentor or your supervisor. And then that's all, you know, they give you an accord and they give you a written letter or, you know, confirmatory email that you can print and attached to your application file. And usually there's a lot of scholarships even associated with you studying, because sometimes your research is quite heavy and require that, you know, you purchase lots of reagents or lots of auxiliary equipments for your private, you know, research or your personalized topic of research. This is quite important. So there is grants, there is scholarships, there is, you know, external support and financial support that you can literally have once you're enrolled or you have this admission letter. So it's very, very important, and you have all these things available and you can have the information handy. So if you need those, I'm gonna try to leave the links in the description box below. And most international students come to study in Japan based on a mixed scholarship, which is offered by the Japanese government. That is quite a huge thing. We're going to talk about that in another video. But for this video, I want to say thank you so much. And this is a recap, is that the University of Tokyo is one of the top universities in the world. It's located here in Tokyo in Honga location or city. You can literally reach them out. The contact details is in the description box below. Next up is that they are very international friendly. A majority of the courses will be offered in English. Next is that you need to know that you need to take a pre-entry test, which is very important. And there are past questions that you can readily have, but you can purchase it for a couple of dollars. It's not expensive. There is a link or the contact in the description box that you can contact them to have it. And next up is that you need to submit all your complete documentations in order for them to check it out. And if you succeed your test and you are admitted, then good luck, congratulations, you're welcome to Japan to study in one of the world's top and best international universities, where you can experience the best life and one of the most greatest cultures in Asia. Next up, please make sure and remember, if you're for the academic part, you need to actually reach out to a researcher who will serve as your mentor or as your supervisor within your time frame of study at the University of Tokyo. So that's all for it. Thank you very much. If you like this video, please thumbs up, subscribe, share, and hit on the notification bell so when we produce a video, you wouldn't miss. And thank you. Bye-bye.